Hello, this is Vipul Murali and I welcome you back to my YouTube channel. And this video also is an experimental video. Which experiment are we going to discuss today? Okay, that is the question in your mind. I'll sort it out. The answer to that is, this time we are going to carry out chemical kinetics. Now, when you talk about chemical kinetics, the first thing which needs to come into our mind, and that is about the speed of the reaction. Or we talk about the rate of the reaction. Okay, that is what chemical kinetics is. So in short, I'll explain you the theory. As I've always been saying, that I'm explaining the theory very short because I don't want to exceed the duration of this video and you will lose the interest, because my prime objective is the demonstration of the experiment. Alright? So, to brief theory with respect to this experiment is, first, starting with the aim of the experiment. What's the aim is? To determine the rate constant. Rate constant is abbreviated as K. So rate constant is K for which reaction? The reaction is hydrolysis of methyl acetate. Okay, what is it? It's hydrolysis of methyl acetate. Now, my dear friends, when we carry out this reaction, hydrolysis reaction of an ester, methyl acetate is an ester. Now, it takes place either in presence of an acid catalyst or a base catalyst. Now, the reaction that we are going to discuss, the experiment that we are going to be discussing in this particular video is about acid catalysis. So, here I will put it down, it is in presence of an acid catalyst. That means obviously the H plus ions are going to be determined to increase the rate of this particular reaction. Alright? Now, next thing is, how the reaction takes place. Let us just write down the reaction. The reaction is methyl acetate. So it is CH3COOCH3 hydrolysis. So you understand this, that is with H2O. The reaction takes place in presence of an acid catalyst. So I write it as H plus ions. Now, what exactly happens is, the bond between the carbon and the oxygen breaks, H2O gets dissociated into H plus and OH minus. Now see what happens is, the bond between carbon and oxygen breaks for this particular ester, let me be very clear, okay, because it all depends upon the type of the ester. So here for this particular ester, the bond between the carbon and the oxygen breaks. Now, it results in the formation of a carbocation and a negatively charged oxygen, because of high electronegativity of oxygen as compared to carbon. So therefore, what happens is the H plus ions now is going to attack the O minus, and therefore the OH minus is going to attack the carbon ion, and as a result of which we get CH3COOH and CH3OH. You know, my dear friends, very well, hydrolysis of an ester results in the formation of a carboxylic acid and alcohol. Alright? Now, the formation of this carboxylic acid, the acetic acid, because it is acidic in nature, we are going to carry out this experiment by means of our titration. Alright, and you know very well, whenever I have an acid, so it has to be titrated against what? Base. So, the acid which is going to be formed over here, acetic acid, can be evaluated, can be estimated by titrating against what? A base, that is NaOH. And it is going to be what? Standardized. So, it means that I already know the concentration of NaOH before I carry out this titration. Okay, that is what is meaning of standardized NaOH. Right? Now, next thing is, what exactly is the formula now as far as the K is concerned? Because our aim of the experiment is to study this reaction and evaluate the rate constant. Alright, so the rate constant, as I said, is going to be abbreviated as K. So, the formula of that is going to be 2.303 upon T into log of A upon A minus of X. Okay, now when we talk about A, it is the initial concentration and X is the amount which is reacted. Now both of these are concentrations, but in this particular experiment, we are going to express it in terms of CMK. Alright, so as a result of which, both these units are same. Okay, this will be CMQ, this also will be what? CMQ. Now this T, that is what time, now here we are going to carry out the chemical reaction at intervals of 10-10 minutes. And therefore, this T will be expressed in what minutes? So this is going to be in cm cube. A minus of x is going to be in cm cube. So those units get cancelled. 2.303, obviously, it's a constant number. And T is in minutes. And therefore, we say the units, when you talk about of k, will be minute inverse. What it will be? Minute inverse. Okay, this will be the units of k. Next thing is, have a look at this particular reaction. Now, if you see this reaction, you'll come to know that there are two molecules. One, the molecule of an ester, the other is a molecule of what? Water. And therefore, we are tempted to say that the reaction is what? Bimolecular. But when we actually study the kinetics of the reaction, then we come to know that the rate of reaction actually depends upon the concentration of the ester. The reason is because the water over here is in excess. And therefore, we say the reaction is first order, and also we call it as a pseudo unimolecular reaction. Pseudo means you know very well it is false. So actually it's a bimolecular reaction, but when you study the kinetics, because water molecule is present in excess, and therefore we call it as what? Pseudo unimolecular reaction, and we also call it as what? A first order reaction. Okay, so this is in short, I try to explain you what exactly the theory all about is with respect to the kinetics of the hydrolysis of ester. I hope you have understood up to this very well. Yes, now I'll explain you the procedure part of this, okay? And then we'll finally go into demonstration. So, procedure part is, what we do is, we take two glass topper bottles. And that bottle has to be what? Dry. So, I'll just show it symbolically how it is going to be. So, consider this as a glass topper bottle. This is one. This is a symbolic representation, so you understand how exactly to execute this particular experiment. So these are, as I mentioned, glass stopper bottles. And of course, the bottles are also made up of glass itself. Please remember this, that will be what? Dry. Now, in one of the bottles, we are going to fill up 100 ml of HCl, 0.5 normal. And here, we are going to take 5 ml of methyl acetate. Okay? And they will be in a water bottle. Both the bottles are going to be where? In the water bottle. Okay, this is the water bottle. Getting it? Once again, I repeat. You take two glass stopper dry bottles. In one of the bottles, you take 100 ml of HCl to a measuring cylinder, and here you are going to take 5 ml of methyl acetate. Okay? And then both these bottles are placed in water bath. Right? Next thing is the butane is filled with 0.1 normal NaOH. It is filled with what? 0.1 normal NaOH. Next thing is, we know about after the butane solution is being filled up with 0.1 normal NaOH, which I told you that was standardized. That means you already know the concentration of NaOH. Next thing is, after a certain time period, okay, certain time, alright, then everything gets settled down. So we have another preparation also, of course you will understand this when I practically demonstrate this, and that is, what you do is, in a particle flask, take around 2 or 3 pieces of ice, Okay, two or three pieces of what? Ice. Please, only two or three pieces is enough. We are not making ice creams over here, my friends. Alright? So, two or three pieces of ice and two to three drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Already it has to be there in the conical flask. Now, what is the role of ice? The simple part is, see, as I told you earlier, chemical kinetics means we talk about the rate of the reaction. We talk about the speed of the reaction. And therefore, the most important factor, and that is going to be what time. So, we are going to carry out the readings at intervals of a particular time. Alright, so what happens is, when we start with the titration process, it does take some time, okay, for the titration to go on and to reach the end point. So I don't want that time also to be included in that reading. Okay, so I want the reaction to stop corresponding to the particular time interval. Okay, suppose I want to take a reading corresponding to 10 minutes. So it has to be strictly corresponding to 10 minutes. Alright, it might take a minute or two extra when we carry out the titration process. So we don't want that. So the purpose of the ice is to stop the reaction at the time interval which I desire. Okay, so that I can get the reading corresponding to that particular time. Understood this? So that is what is the function of ice. So in the conical flask, we are going to take two or three pieces of ice and two or three drops of the phenolphthalein indicator in the beginning itself. Okay. Now once all these arrangement is done, okay, now what you do is you remove both the bottles out of the water bath and you are going to mix the contents of both the bottles. Now mixing always, remember in kinetics, whenever I want to mix the two solutions having unequal volume, then the larger volume will always go into the smaller volume. So as a result of which, what will happen is the HCl will go into what? Without. Of course, by opening the quantities. Okay? So that's very simple. So you need to just convert or transfer this HCl into what? Without acid. Okay, so therefore, what we have is 105 ml. Okay? Logically speaking, 105 ml of the reaction mixture. Okay, we are called as reaction mixture. Now what we do is 5 cm3 of that reaction mixture is immediately prepared. Is immediately. Okay? Also, please remember to note the time of mixing. Okay, so for example, that time is say T. Okay, so two things you need to do. First thing is, you are going to mix 100 ml of HCl into methyl acid and transfer that, okay, into the ester. Next is, you cork it once again. Now this bottle will become empty. Now this bottle contains the reaction mixture. Cork it and shake it very well. Okay, and then you are going to note down the time of mixing and immediately you are going to prepare down 5 cm of the reaction mixture into the conical flask which already contains ice and 2 or 3 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Please remember this. Okay, don't do it like you have already prepared it out and now you are searching around, you are in there for ice and for phenolphthalein and all that. No, because these are time bound experiments, my dear friends. Alright, see, as long as two bottles are separate, let it be in the water bath. Okay, at that time, we are not going to be so strict in our first place, what is the timing? Because the reaction is not started. The reaction starts only when the contents of both the bottles are mixed. So, once the mixing is done, okay, you have to be very careful with respect to the time part. Alright, so, I hope you have understood this entire process. So, 5 cm of conical flask, or of the reaction mixture is being prepared in the conical flask immediately. Okay, and you are going to titrate versus NaOH, which is here in the unit, and the color change, you know it very well. NaOH is basic, phenolphthalein in the basic medium shows a pink coloration, so therefore it has to be what? Pink. Okay, so color has to pink, and that reading is being denoted as a T0 reading. What is it denoted as T0? Because we have immediately prepared it out, okay, from the reaction mixture. So that reading is easy. Now, next thing is, from the time T at intervals of 10 minutes. Okay, from the time t at intervals of 10 minutes, we are going to take readings. So that means that will correspond to 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50 minutes. Okay, these are the readings which has to be taken. So how many readings? 5 readings plus T0. So that means total will be how many? 6 readings here today. At every point of time, please make sure that once you get your pink coloration, wash the conical plaster anywhere. Okay, because you have a time interval of 10 minutes. So hardly you require a couple of minutes for the dilation to get over. Okay, next is empty the contents of the conical flask, which is pink in color. Wash the conical flask thoroughly well with water. There should not be any traces of the solution of the previous one. Okay, now once the conical flask is washed, next is what you do is 2 or 3 pieces of ice and phenolphthalein indicator. Keep everything ready. Fill the period once again to 0 level. Alright, all these things you have to do within what? 10 minutes. Okay, and then as soon as the 10 minutes is over, what you have to do is you open the contents of this bottle. Okay, pip it out, 5 ml of the reaction mixture into the conical flask, already containing ice and phenolphthalein, and start the titration once again till you get what? Pink color. So that will be the next reading. And in this way, you are going to carry out the readings. So the readings, total number of readings which have to be taken for this experiment are how many? 6. Okay, so I hope you have understood up to this very well. Now, my dear friends, we start with the actual demonstration of this experiment. So, to begin with, we have 2 glass stoppered bottles. Okay, it's a glass stoppered bottle. Now, one of them has to be filled with methyl acetate and the other has to be with HCl. Alright, so, my dear friends, this is methyl acetate. Okay, we have done it in the burette because it's harmful to directly pipette out 5 ml of the ester. Okay, it's not good enough. The ester vapors are not good enough. Alright, so we are going to fill it up with what? In the burette. And also you can see at the top, okay, there is a cotton wool which is being kept over here because methyl acetate is volatile. Alright, so in order to prevent its escaping, so we are going to use this cotton wool. So, how much we are going to take? 5 ml. Okay. So that is, it is 5 ml and we are immediately corking it and we are going to keep it in what? The water bath. Okay, in one of the water bath. Right? So this is one solution. Next is, we have the another glass stopper bottle into which we are going to take HCl through this measuring cylinder of 100 ml. HCl concentration is, you can check it out, it's 0.5 normal HCl. So we are taking 100 ml. And we are going to transfer this very slowly into the bottle. And we cork it and keep it in the water bath. Alright, so that is it. We have in one of the glass stoppered bottle 100 ml of HCl. In the another bottle we have 5 ml of methyl acetate. Okay, so this is there. We have not mixed the solution as yet, my dear friend. So no worries about the timing parts. Okay, the timing part becomes very crucial when we mix both the solutions, because as soon as we mix, Okay, what happens is, yes, the reaction starts, right? So, next arrangement what has to be done is, yes, you can see over here, this is a butane, which is being filled with what? NaOH. Because when this reaction takes place, I've already explained to you the reaction, it results in the formation of acetic acid. And that acid can be titrated against NaOH. So, the butane is being filled with 0.1 normal NaOH. So, that one arrangement is done. Next one is, this is the conical flask, my dear friends. Okay, this is what? The conical flask. Now, in this conical flask, what are we going to do is, we are already going to add few pieces of ice. Okay, so just few pieces, couple of pieces are enough, as I already told you. And that is, we are not going to make ice creams over here. Okay, so these two pieces, two or three pieces are sufficient. Next thing is, we are going to add into it two or three drops of the phenolphthalein indicator. After the ice pieces, we are going to add two or three drops of the phenolphthalein indicator into this. Okay, so now this all arrangement is being ready. Okay, that means the conical flask contains ice as well as phenolphthalein indicator. The solution is filled with NaOH. We have got two glass topped bottles in the respective water bar, HCl as well as methyl acetate. Now once you are very confident that yes, you are in a position to take the reading, then only you are going to mix the solutions. Am I very clear with this? So, we begin with. This is a 5 ml of pipette which we are going to use it. So what we do now is, we are going to use a funnel. We'll bring both the bottles out of the water bar, open the cork of it. This is HCl, that is 100 ml. So the larger volume will go into the smaller volume. So theoretically speaking, this bottle gets empty, so we'll just keep it aside. I just swirl this water. This is a reaction mixture. Theoretically speaking, it should be 105 ml. We'll pip it out 5 ml of the reaction mixture. Cork the bottle immediately. And we are going to start off with the titration process. Against anyway from the beer. The end point, as everybody knows, it has to be what? Pink in color. Pink color do appear, but then on shaking, it disappears. So that is not going to be our end point. Even after shaking, the pink color should remain at least for a few milliseconds. So the time which is being involved during this attainment of the indicator, so that time should not come in, so that is the reason we are using ice. So the reaction is already stopped, so no worries about that. this is it, my dear friends. Just one more drop. So it becomes pink. And the reading is going to be 21.3. So my dear friends, I hope you have understood this. This reading will be denoted as what? T0 reading. Because this is the reading which we have taken immediately after mixing. Okay, so this is T0. Now we have already noted down the time when we have mixed the two solutions. Now from that time onwards, not this time of completion of the reaction, from that time onwards, at interval of 10 minutes, we are going to take the reading. We are going to wash away this particle flask thoroughly well for the second reading that we need to take. Because if there are some traces of the previous solution, then what happens is, as soon as we add ice and the phenolphthalein indicator, then the solution turns pink, which should not happen. It should remain colorless only. So we are going to wash it thoroughly well. We are going to add some ice pieces into this. Even if the cold water is there, to a certain extent it's okay. Now we are going to add into it two or three drops of the indicator. See this? Okay, it is not turning pink. So it is very clear that there are no traces of the previous solution. You need to fill up the burette with NaOH, and then as per the timing is concerned, you have to pipette it out once again, 5 ml. Okay, this is the procedure that you have to repeat it, okay, for 5 times, and accordingly we get the readings corresponding to T10, T20, T30, T40 and T50. Alright, so I hope you have understood this entire process very well. Now my friends, once we have recorded the readings, okay, taken the readings, total readings, how many will we have taken? 6. One is T0 and then 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Now these readings which we have taken, now it has to be recorded in a particular format. Okay, so I am showing the observation table. Now, what we do is, first of all is, we need to mention the T0 reading. Dash CNT. Okay, you know what is T0 reading. Next thing we go into T infinity. Now what is T infinity that I'll tell you? The reading procedure is the same, but the timing is important. Okay? This reading has to be taken around 24 hours from the time T. I hope you understand the word, what time am I talking about? Yes. The time of mixing of HCl into methyl acetate. I told you, you have to note down the timing. So whatever the time that you have noted from that 24 hours, okay, so that is today at 9 o'clock in the morning, I have mixed the two solutions, HCl going into methyl acetate. So tomorrow at 9 o'clock, I have to pipette it out, okay, because see, we have a total, theoretically speaking, 105 ml of the reaction mixture. And how many readings we have taken is 6. Every time we are pipetting out 5. So that means 30 ml is consumed. We still have theoretically 75 ml still remaining. Okay, so keep it as it is. And after 24 hours, you prepare out once again 5 ml of that reaction mixture into a particle flask. Okay, same procedure. Titrate it against NaOH till you get what? Pink coloration. And that reading after 24 hours is considered as an infinity reading. And that is what we are going to record it over here. So T infinity is equal to dash CNT. Okay, now remind you the observation table. Now when we consider the observation table, so the first column that we are going to consider is time. Okay, small t. T0 already written at the top of the observation table. So we can directly start with 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Okay, and the units you know very well, it is minutes. It's not hours, it is minutes. Understood this? Next is, we have a tighter reading corresponding to all these time intervals. So that we call it as TT. So at 10 minutes, whatever we get, next is 20 minutes, next is 30 minutes and on. Okay, remember this, that the extent of the reaction between the methyl acetate, okay, and the NCl Okay, it's directly proportional to time. So as the time increases, the rate of the reaction also increases, the extent of reaction also increases, and therefore the lighter value will go on increasing as we go from 10 minutes to 50 minutes. So this is titrating, that is TT. Okay, next thing is we go into X. Now what is X is equal to? TT minus of T0. Because see, T0 is immediately after mixing. So obviously, when we are going to take total 6 readings, the lowest reading will be T0. Okay, and as I said, as the time increases, the reading will also increase. So therefore, the TT minus of T0 will be always positive. So whatever reading that we have here, okay, this is to be subtracted from this and that will come as X. Next we have is A minus of X. So that A minus of X will be equal to T infinity minus TT. Okay, that is the formula. So T infinity will be getting it over here. So that is after 24 hours, whatever the reading that we get, that has to be loaded over here. And then TT is these readings. So you subtract it, you get what? A minus of X. Next part is, we take the logarithm of this. So log of A minus of X. And then finally, we go into what? Yes. The aim of the experiment is what? To find out the rate of the reaction. So formula, which I have already discussed with you all, 2.303 upon T into log of A upon A minus of X. Okay, A is in cm cube, A minus of X is in cm cube. So when you go for the units, okay, the cm cube gets cancelled. So what happens is inverse of T. And the T is expressed in terms of what? Minutes. And therefore, we come to the conclusion that K units will be what? Minute inverse. So my dear friends, this is the observation table in which you need to record the reading and you need to calculate the values and then finally get the rate constant. Okay? And then you can go for the mean also. And that is, you take all the 5, add all these 5 and then divide it by 5. So you get the final value of K, and this K is going to be the rate constant of the hydrolysis reaction of butyl acetate in presence of acid catalyst. I hope you have understood this very well.